Honorable Chairman, to start with, I would like to place on record the gratitude of the 5 crore people of the state of Andhra Pradesh to Honorable Chairman, leaders of various parties and Honorable members of this August House for enabling a detailed discussion on their agony and anguish even after 4 years of the hasty, unscientifically prepared and politically motivated bifurcation of the undivided Andhra Pradesh, sir. The frustration and helplessness of the people of Andhra Pradesh has serious implications for the future of our country as it rightly aspires to find its due place in the comity of nations. The future of aspirational India would be in serious jeopardy if the neglect of Andhra Pradesh over the last 4 years were to continue. That is why we sought this debate, sir. The future of the people of Andhra Pradesh is in dark, mainly on account of the following 9 reasons. Blatant violations by this government of various provisions of the sacred Constitution of India. Neglect of Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act passed by the Supreme Legislature of our country, including this August House. Willful burial of the decision of the Union Cabinet in respect of special category status for Andhra Pradesh. Fourth point, calculated and motivated non-compliance with the assurances and promises made by the Honorable Prime Minister of our country on the floor of this August House in respect of the state of Andhra Pradesh at the time of creation by the present state. Point number 5, publicly proclaimed political philosophy of the ruling party, the BJP, that politics is all for the power. Sixth point is carefully orchestrated misinformation campaign against the state of Andhra Pradesh with regard to the special category status and central assistance being given under the so-called special package. Seventh point, huge dichotomy between the words and deeds of Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Finance Minister. Eighth point, blatant violation of the spirit of cooperative federalism on which this diverse and large country needs to be run. Ninth point, demonstrated failure on the part of the Government of India in implementing the act which is passed by both the houses, though 4 years is elapsed. Sir, it shall be my endeavor to present our case in favor of the people of Andhra Pradesh and against the Government of India within the time given to me. I would not like to go into too many statistics regarding the pitiable state of the Andhra Pradesh when it was brought into being and our genuine claims for assistance and what the government did. I would like to present our case in the perspective of the guarantees available to the people of the neglected Andhra Pradesh within the contours of the Constitution of India and the basic principles of our parliamentary democracy and the mindset of this government, sir. Before I do so, let me throw some light on what is happening to my state and the perceptions of the 5 crore people going on for the past 4 years. Sir, lynching is the flavor of the season in our country for some time now, and there has been a widespread concern over the same. Dictionary meaning of lynching is a group of a mob killing someone for an alleged offense without a trial. The people of my state feel there is a centrally sponsored lynching going on against them as they are forced to bleed for resources and central assistance by being deprived of their entitlements. And what is the offense committed by the people of Andhra Pradesh? The offenses is they believed in the central government of the day. They believed in BJP for about four long years, sir. I know I am using a harsh language, but I have no other option to highlight the injustice being done to the state and the people of Andhra Pradesh. I do hope and expecting some relief from this debate to get support from this August House from every member and every party. This August House is the Council of States. Andhra Pradesh is a constitutional constituent of the Union of India, and one would expect this August House to come to the relief of the distraught and worried people of Andhra Pradesh in their hour of distress and despair on account of the cool and calculated machinations of the central government against my state and its people. We are entitled to protection from the House by making the government to make amendments to their questionable attitude and approach towards my state. Sir, let me know briefly now, briefly elaborate on the nine reasons that I gave for taking the...
You have to keep your time in mind.
Yes, sir.
No party has given me in writing or orally saying that they are giving their time to...
I think you can take the clarification, sir, if need be, and we will adjust.
If anybody does, I will be happy.
Yeah, huh? No problem. No.
Proportionate time is over. That's the problem.
No.
No, no, I will allow him. They have given six names. No, no.
This was one. Sir, even the Congress has given their time, sir.
As to how to solve this problem.
I have no problem.
Chairman was kind enough.
I think
chairman was
kind enough.
I am just discussion. I am just cautioning Chowdary because others will lose time.
No.
If any party comes forward, I will be more than.
I think my submission would be that okay, we can have half an hour extra.
Yes, sir.
And
yes,
that
sir.
Can be.
It is easy to say, sir, take 1 hour extra and then give all that to others. But what he suggested is that if
Thank
any
you.
Party is ready
Thank
to part with
sir.
Their time.
Sir, let me now briefly elaborate on the nine reasons that I have.
1 minute, Mr. Chowdary. The discussion, I don't want to obstruct you. You are a leader of the party also and also a senior colleague. I want you to have a free say. The total time allocated is 2 hours 30 minutes will not be extended under any circumstances. Keep that in mind. And any party coming forward, I will cut it from that time. If the Congress is willing, I have no problem. I will welcome it and then do some time. I suggest. Mr. Chowdary. So keep that in mind.
Yes,
you are
sir,
the first speaker. You are the first speaker. Please go
with
ahead.
With due respect, sir.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir,
I have extended. That's why I extended to two and a half hours. Earlier, the suggestion was should I repeat
sir,
what happened there?
My humble request is at least kindly allow us to express our anguish,
no, no.
Sir.
Not for anything. House has to be.
Sir, let me now briefly elaborate on the nine reasons that I gave for seeking this important debate. Article 4 of our Constitution clearly stipulated that if any state, if bifurcated under Article 3, then supplemental, incidental and consequential measures can be taken by the Parliament. Andhra Pradesh is a fit case for such intervention. But what is happening, sir? The government has refused to meet our demand of amending the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act to address the vagueness of language contained therein regarding the development of Andhra Pradesh and assisting the same. And instead, the government is taking cover under such vague expression of the act to suit their mindset against the state. Decisions of Union Cabinet have a certain constitutional sanctity, but this government has ignored the Cabinet decision of 1st March 2014 conferring special category status on our state. This is yet another blatant violation of the constitution of our country. Sir, on the floor of this very August House, the then Prime Minister on 20th February 2014 gave six assurances, including special category status for Andhra Pradesh. But all these are being brazenly violated. So we need protection from this House and hence this debate, sir. Sir, Honorable Prime Minister, during his election campaign, not once but thrice, publicly assured the people of Andhra Pradesh at Guntur, Nellore and the temple town of Tirupati that AP will be given special category status not for 5 years but promised as 10 years whereas Congress have promised only 5 years. Hence, this debate is very important for us, sir. This demonstrated disconnect between the words and the deeds of Sri Modi is a matter of serious concern not only for the people of Andhra Pradesh but for the country as well. This government does not seem to be having trust and confidence in the missionary and leadership of states bridging the revenue deficit for the 10-month period from the date of residuary state of Andhra Pradesh coming into being until March 2015 is a major case in point. AP government, while under presidential rule, projected this deficit as 16,000 78 crore rupees. CAG upheld this figure. That is, presidential rule can be constituted as if it is under central government rule. But the members of this August House would be surprised to know that the Prime Minister's office, in their wisdom, reduced it drastically to rupees 4,117 crores without explaining any reason, sir. Sir, is the PMO meant to examine the expenditure reports of states and decide on them? What mandate and missionary does PMO have to do so, sir? PMO, it seems, does not trust a constitutionally constituent of the Union of India, that is Andhra Pradesh. Where is this country being led to by such a PMO doing such micromanagement of expenditure in states, and that too distrusting every institution and individual? That is why we sought this debate, sir. If the Government of India, under the visionary and able leadership of Honorable Prime Minister, is propelled by such manifest distrust of the states and chief ministers and state governments, where are we being led? This House needs to know. Sir, yet another manifestation of this mission distrust is the misleading campaign being orchestrated by the Government of India. Unashamedly and with utter disregard to facts, this government has been misleading the media and the people of Andhra Pradesh and this country that the 14th Finance Commission has said no more special category status to any states, which is far from the truth, sir. On the contrary, the then Minister of Planning, Sri Rao Indrajit Singh, in reply to an unstarred question number 2360 on 15th March 2018, informed this very August House, and I quote, "The 14th Finance Commission in its recommendations has not made any specific reference not to confer special category status to any state," I unquote. Sir, my question is how the government of the day says something contrary to what the Rajya Sabha was told in writing. This House has a right to reprimand the government for this deliberate misinformation campaign and compromising with the honor of this House. That is why we sought this House and the support of every member of this House, sir. This clearly shows the lack of will and coordination between the departments. Sir, all this misinformation campaign and utter disregard for the Constitution of India and the Parliament, for the fundamental principles of parliamentary democracy and cooperative federalism, and the spirit of so-called Team India, besides the mismatch in the words and deeds of this government, have deep roots somewhere. It is in the publicly stated political philosophy of the ruling party, that is BJP. Sir, a high-level functionary of BJP speaking at the state-level executive meeting in Warangal in Telangana on July 23, 2000 said, and I quote, "Politics have to be cold-blooded. Politics are not for doing charity. We do politics only to capture power. The aim of politics is to capture power. There is no scope for emotions in politics," unquote. This brazen advocacy of the theory of politics for power, politics of power, sir, in my view, holds the key to what is happening now for the state of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, I would like to ask this August House, through you, which is the Elders House, if playing divisive politics with the future of 5 crore people of Andhra Pradesh.
Focus on your issues, because Trinamool and TDP both time also is over. Please.
Of Andhra Pradesh, is it in the interest of the country? Question. Is this the way to shape a new India that the Honorable Prime Minister often talks about? I am afraid, certainly not. So this debate is very important, sir. Kindly bear with us, sir. On behalf of the people of Andhra Pradesh, I would like to assert in this House that we are not seeking any charity or undue favour from this government or the ruling BJP. We are only demanding what is due to the people of Andhra Pradesh as a matter of right, as per the Act, along with the assurances of the Prime Minister given on the floor of this August House on 20th February 2014, assurances of the Prime Minister made on several occasions. Sir, soon after this government assumed office, you advised the ministers and members of this House not to use the colonial language. I beg to raise, as colonial times are over, but not in reality, sir. Going by the way this government is conducting itself in the way it is giving governance. The Chief Minister, myself, and along with all of my colleagues were forced to go around many offices begging one after one for what was due to us a matter of right over the last 4 years. It is new colonialism of BJP variety we are tasting, sir. Really sad times for a new India of Sri Modi's dreams. This needs to be checked. It is the states that make the Union of India and not by just BJP alone. Sir, let me now present a synoptic view of the failure of Andhra Pradesh and what they are supposed to give to the people of Andhra Pradesh. The government of the state of Andhra Pradesh, with all responsibility and humility as a constituent of the Union of India, estimate a total resource requirement of about 1.5 lakhs crores for various aspects of development of the resource starved state. Contrary, the misleading claims of the government and the BJP, all that we have received so far just rupees 13,708 crores during the past 4 years from the central government. Sir, at this rate, it would take 44 years for the central government to aid the state government to stand on its own. So then only it can think of coming to the level playing field, sir. Just
I have to
please,
call
sir,
the
please,
next
sir, please,
speaker,
sir.
Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad.
I would like to ask please. This government.
Half of the time I have given to you.
Through you, sir. It is just for 5 minutes, sir.
15 minutes.
To clarify, sir. Sir, excuse me, sir. You have taken five to seven minutes, sir, in between. Yes, sir. While talking to all the people. Sir,
it's totally unfair.
Sir, that is humble.
If you want to go by then rule, then I have to go by rule.
No, sir. Sir,
I have been liberal. I said take 15 minutes. 15 minutes. That's what I am asking.
Just give me another 7 minutes, sir.
No, it's not.
So to clarify, if this time
then
frame,
if you are foregoing other speakers, yes, you can.
If the people of AP were to pay for so long for the divisive politics, it is not certainly
put the chair in embarrassing situation.
Was, sir, as a part of their cool and calculated efforts to deny us of what was due to us, the central government tormented us with their inconsistent statements. Backward districts of Andhra Pradesh were to get special assistance at par with similarly placed. The fact being that we got only rupees 428 per capita, while KPK district get rupees 4,115 per head. Is this not a clear case of breach of promise and discrimination, sir? We don't complain against what others are getting. We are only asking for what was issued to us, but the theory of power politics of BJP seems to be clearly coming in the way. Very sad for us and for this country, sir. The other day, while responding to the debate on the no confidence motion in the other house, Honorable Prime Minister said that APCM has taken a U-turn on our ties with the BJP. What is the option left to us, sir, after having patiently waited for 4 years, hoping against the hope that the BJP would do justice one day or other, and with no sign of any redemption of such
right, Mr. Chowdary,
in turn, what we got is blame and betrayal. Sir,
Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad, please.
Another 4 minutes.
You just answer me. If you want to, if you want entire time to be taken by you, I have no problem.
No, sir. My request.
I have no problem at all.
Sir, my request.
You are taking your party's time and others' time also.
No, sir. If others has got problem, we will work out at that point of.
No. You have to either way.
No, sir.
You have to go by the chair or you have to.
I can only request, sir. I can only request. We know where, under which regime we are. We can only request, sir. Please kindly permit.
There is nothing to do with the regime.
Sir.
I'm sorry. I'm seeing the way.
Sir,
this is the regime.
Sir,
not following the rule, sir, is not the regime.
Nobody else is objecting, sir. Kindly, my request, sir.
Okay.
How could we have one more minute, please, close. Sir, fine.
So you go through the sheet, four minutes are allotted to TDP.
I have allowed publicly proclaimed
19 minutes,
political philosophy
minutes
of coming to power in a state like Andhra Pradesh at our party's cost.
It's not fair.
And even if it meant starving the people of the state for resources that were their right.
Right, Chowdary.
Our Chief Minister, Sri Chandrababu Naidu, is one of the few senior most and experienced leaders of our country who has contributed to the nation building all these years. Sir, to give this August House one example that holds mirror to the mindset of this government, I would like to refer to this, the issue of railway zone for AP. Does it take 4 long years to decide and tell us whether it is possible or not? Does this reflect properly on the government that claims to be decisive in taking the nation to the new heights? Certainly not. That is why we sought this special debate,
right,
sir.
Chowdary.
Sir, kindly.
Good.
Sir, the fact of the matter is, is the BJP
minutes,
who have taken a clear U-turn violating the principles of
Chowdary,
friendship and political
very,
moral.
You are a very highly educated and cultured person, bear with me.
Sir, my colleagues are willing to give, sir. Yeah. Sir, please.
Who are the colleagues? Let them
come. Within my party, sir. Please.
Then if that is the case,
okay.
I have no problem.
Okay, we will work it out,
okay,
sir. So, the fact of the matter is that is BJP who have taken a clear U-turn violating the principles of friendship and political morality. They scheme to destroy the TDP with the sole aim of expanding their political space in the state. For this reason, we had part ways with a heavy heart. We had to do so since the Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Modi, wants to build a new India but refuses to embrace the people of Andhra Pradesh in their hour of distress and despair. Sir, I would like to assure this August House that all through the last 4 years, we have been on the steady and right course based on the principles of friendship, political morality, constitutionalism, and cooperative federalism. Here, but what is happening, sir? There is a parallel political pattern unfolding in Andhra Pradesh, even as our CM was struggling day and night to build the future of the people of Andhra Pradesh. The core element of this pattern has been the BJP has begun to discover a new, your sincere and reliable compromised partner, YSRCP, having located such friendship.
Chowdary,
BJP
don't take the name of other
no
parties,
more.
Then they will.
I never said, I said your sincere and reliable compromised party, YSRCP, that is my TDP for them, sir. BJP through there is no more use of TDP. Sir, can I ask this government why they failed to implement at least the package announced on 8 September 2016 by the Honorable Finance Minister for the past 2 years. Sir, the government have constituted subgroup of chief ministers to study rationality of centrally sponsored schemes for special category states. Based on the recommendations of the Niti Aayog, have issued office memorandum on 17th August 2016 addressing the special category issues of various states. What made government not to include Andhra Pradesh along with these states? We are not able to understand. Sir, I would like to sensitize this house about morality versus majority. I also mentioned several times in this August house that our founding fathers, freedom fighters, bought independence by Quit India movement. But both the parties, unfortunately, now they are making politics by Split India for political gains. Sir, I would like to remind this August house that many states of our country has got single digit representation to parliament, which is a temple of democracy. But we have to respect the member, not the member, sir. Fortunately, this house has got all the people like our present chairman, present leader of the house, the then leader of the house and the prime minister are still available to witness what is happening to the state of Andhra Pradesh, what has happened on that day, about the promises and assurances given on various times, sir. This
right.
debate is make
okay,
a fervent appeal to Honorable Prime Minister Sri Modi and the Government of India come to rescue of the people of Andhra Pradesh. AP ko bachao, AP ko badao. Let AP be saved, let AP progress. Sir, in the end, I would like to frame our demands as follows. Honor the decision of the Union Cabinet conferring special category status of Andhra Pradesh. Implement all the points with true letter and spirit of the Act, along with assurances given on the floor of the House by the Prime Minister. As a constitutional constitute of the Union of India, Andhra Pradesh has the right to seek proper response from the Government of India, and the Council of States is the right forum for it, sir.
Thank
so,
you,
Andhra wala, bheek maangne wala nahi hai, sab, hamara iccha nahi hai, irada nahi hai, hamara ko bhi ek maryada hai, wo maryada ke hisab se hi puch raha, kuch bhi jyada to nahi maang raha. Thank you, Chairman, sir, for giving me this opportunity.